Even just these scenes are incredibly epic. It's kind of thinned out a little bit where we're sitting right now. Before, there were a lot of fans. Now they're going to where Dog Walk is, which is just over my left shoulder. But as you watch it, I think that's Kirby Smart. Yep, there's Kirby Smart right now. And look at him just pumping everybody up. This has got to be so unbelievable for Kirby. I said it earlier. He's a guy that's been around Athens his whole life, played in a Georgia Bulldogs uniform, now coached his alma mater to a national championship. What is Kirby building here?
Well, you know, I think he's not here by accident. A guy who has loved Georgia, he was a rabid fan with a dream of playing there. And then my guess is he always knew he wanted to be a coach. And he probably didn't know if he wanted to be a coach at a certain level. And then when he got to Georgia, I think he realized, I want to be the head coach at Georgia. And he probably put that in his mind early on. And again, you talk about the discipline it takes for him to not only accomplish getting to be the head coach of Georgia, but then to ultimately deliver them a national championship. I heard a lot of people take it, oh, we've dethroned Alabama and we're going to win eight. The fact that they've won one, it's incredibly a difficult thing to do. And I don't think it's going to be his last one, but I do think he has probably at some point this week sat back with his wife and just kind of reflected and probably said, like, holy crap, I just accomplished my goal, and let's go.
The crazy thing is, like, you look at Georgia and Alabama, in my opinion, and you talked about winning more than one, because I agree with you. I could absolutely see this being one of, you know, two or three in a five-year window because of the way he recruits. But Georgia is positioned for great long-term success. Kirby's in his mid-40s. In my opinion, he's not going anywhere. He's at his alma mater, and he's at an alma mater that has every resource in the world to continue to win championships. And he doesn't strike me as a guy who would leave for the pros. I think he's – him being from Georgia, this being his home – I mean, you don't get that a lot. And a lot of times in this profession, guys just want to leave for greener grass or higher paid jobs. Georgia is better positioned for long-term success than any other program in college football right now.
Yeah, I don't disagree with that. And, you know, he was under Nick Saban for so long, and he said that just working under Nick Saban, he got to see how difficult, number one, it is to win a national championship and how much work it takes to win a national championship. Kirby was sitting up there, I'll never forget. At 9 a.m., I was in that post-press conference that you do when the champions win. And he literally said what bothered him is that he wasn't already on the road recruiting. This guy goes 365 days a year. He's always thinking about recruiting. His wife told me that when she was on my podcast. He was built to build something in Athens, and I think we're seeing that today.